Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to go over the role that the two peptide hormones, insulin and glucagon, have in the regulation of blood glucose levels. Insulin and glucagon are both produced in the pancreas and secreted into the bloodstream by clusters of islet cells in areas of the pancreas called islets of Langerhans. The islets of Langerhans consists of a cluster of islet cells responsible for secreting hormones. Within the clusters of islet cells, there are alpha cells that secrete glucagon, as well as beta cells that secrete insulin. There are also delta cells that secrete somatostatin. The body requires glucose as a source of making energy in the form of ATP during cellular respiration. The amount of glucose the body needs changes in relation to demand. It is important that the body regulates glucose levels, as high levels of glucose in the blood actually causes cell damage. The two hormones, insulin and glucagon, act in opposition to each other. Insulin causes a decrease in blood glucose concentrations, whereas glucagon causes an increase in blood glucose concentrations. In times when glucose concentrations in the blood are high, which often occurs after one eats, the body releases insulin from beta cells within the islets of Langerhans in the pancreas. This in turn causes blood glucose levels to decrease. This decrease in glucose levels in the blood can be from an increase in glucose breakdown through increased levels of cellular respiration. It can also be from the stimulation of glycogen synthesis in the liver. This process, called glycogenesis, forms glycogen from the glucose, taking the glucose out of the blood. Insulin can also promote the uptake of glucose by adipose tissue. In times when glucose concentrations in the blood are low, which often occurs after exercise, the body releases glucagon from alpha cells within the islets of Langerhans in the pancreas. This in turn causes blood glucose levels to increase. The increase in glucose levels in the blood can be from a reduction in the rate of cellular respiration, which in turn means less glucose is used from the bloodstream. It can also be from the stimulation of the breakdown of glycogen stored in the liver and skeletal muscle back into glucose to enter the bloodstream. This process is called glycogenolysis. Thank you for watching. If you want to support this channel, please subscribe and check out more of my videos.